Hi guys, welcome back to Majestic Notion. Welcome to A Beautiful Perception. How are you guys? Thank you guys so much for your likes, your shares, your subscriptions, and your beautiful comments as I do read them. Thank you so much for your enlightened energy and positive feedback. So thank you. I hope you guys have liked the readings so far and that you're resonating with the readings and that you got a little more insight into your connection. Today we're doing something different. We're going to address the elephant in the room this time, okay? Because for a lot of readings I have gotten a past person, a lurker, someone that keeps watching, is still in your energy. So we're going to see, we're going to pull this person into the forefront here and really see what it is and why this person is still hanging around your energy. So we're going to go ahead. We're going to talk about it. We're going to talk about the ghost from the past. Yes, indeed. As to, you know, we're going to get into what the connection was all about. What is their current energy like? And what are they thinking at this time when it comes to your connection? And what are their fears? And then finally, we're going to get into what their current thoughts are. You know, for those of you who are still curious and want to know, you know, perhaps what's going on with them. You know, sometimes it's a separation that happened within a twin flame connection because one person was way too deep in the darkness with addictions and self-indulgence and all of that. And others of you, it could just be ex-karmic or an ex-soulmate or an ex-karmic soulmate. So we're going to see what energies we pick up on today, and hopefully a lot of you will resonate with this type of connection. And let's pull it apart. Let's address the elephant in the room, guys. Let's get into it. So I'm going to use several decks today as I usually do. Also, I want to welcome my new subscribers to the channel. Thank you for being here. This is a new reading for all of you. I just want to finally bring it to light, pick it apart, and see, because I'm seeing this energy circling to the surface around again, because, you know, these dark energies that we dealt with or these addictions are coming to light, trying to dissipate. And I feel like that's why this energy has resurfaced heavily lately. So let's go ahead and get into it, guys. Let me go on this side first. So let's go ahead and see, what is the connection all about? What is your connection all about with this past person or the person you're in separation with? Whether they did you dirty or you're just separated. Let's see. Why are they hanging around? Your energy. One more shuffle, my guy. And yes, my spirit team surrounds me at this time. Let's see what's going on. So we have courthouse number 23, which adds up to 5. So definitely something challenging. We have main male number 1. And we have a message of concern, also adds up to 5. Wow. Okay, so this is what this connection was all about. We shall see. Okay. So let's get into that was the Kipper deck, by the way. Let's get into the Island Time Wellness deck. Let's see what else we have here. So what was this connection all about? One more shuffle. All right. Let's talk about courthouse. Love call. Someone expresses love, a message of love, thinking of you and letting you know. So I feel you're connected to someone here. You had like a contract with someone here with this courthouse thing. For some of you, there's someone in jail that you separated from and they're calling you from jail. Let's see what else. Main mail. So this person is still looking at your photographs, missing you, nostalgia, make new memories. Okay. And message of concern, not showing true feelings, hide personality, pretend, dilute, and gaslighting.
Okay. So we're dealing with someone that perhaps they were too much in ego and pride to tell you how they felt, but they felt something. If they had to hide it, they felt it. And if they're still looking at your photographs, it's for a reason. They have feelings that they didn't tell you about. And I feel like they're concerned here. Maybe they saw something on social media because they're looking at your pictures, things you post. And I don't know, they saw something concerning, but they're not letting you know they're watching, okay? Whether it's concerning to them, maybe you're with someone else, dating someone new, who knows? But I feel like they want to express how they feel, okay? Because they're thinking of you and wanting to let you know, but they're wearing a mask. So, you're dealing with someone here, obviously, and you know this, that just didn't let you know how they felt. They hid it from you, and it's probably because it was intense, okay? So, let's see what their current energy is like. We're going to use the Elqui deck. Let's see what their current energy is like. One more shuffle, my guides. Alright. He or she who hopes, love, hope, and relationships. So I'm seeing they're hopeful for something between you guys still. Okay? Because this is their current energy. So they're hopeful for something here. They're looking at your photographs. They want to express how they feel because they know that it's a concern to you that they never showed you their feelings, perhaps, as well. And maybe they want to express this because they saw something. Maybe you're dating or you're single, loving your life, happy. You know, because there could have been some time that passed between you and this person. So, now that we know where their current energy is, love, hope, relationships, let's get into what they're thinking when it comes to this connection at this time, okay? We're going to use the Arcanum Tarot for that. So what are they currently thinking about the connection at this time? Your connection, what are they so hopeful about? One more shuffle. What are they thinking about the connection? Let's see. Ace of Wands. Okay, so they're hopeful they can rekindle this spark, is what I'm seeing. And hopeful that perhaps they can have some type of union with you as well. But they're thinking perhaps they missed this opportunity with you, okay? Four of Cups is missed opportunity. It's, you know, thinking about what coulda, shoulda, woulda been. And, you know, there might be concern that someone else is coming into your life as well. All right, let's see what else. Queen of Cups, yeah. They feel they missed an opportunity with someone that truly loved this person. Water sign aside, Scorpio, Pisces, Cancer. Everyone has emotions that they hold dear in their heart. And this is someone that is very loving, caring. Someone that loves deeply. So there was love here. All right. It hovers over their head, and they feel they missed an opportunity with someone that loved them perhaps unlike any other. But they're also hopeful that they can rekindle this. But what they're currently thinking when it comes to this connection is that they missed this opportunity. Obviously, you know, if you guys are separated, have gone your own ways, whether you want this person back or not, this is what they're thinking. So, Page of Pentacles. They're thinking that perhaps they need to reach out. They want to reach out when it comes to this connection. maybe apologize for what they did. All right. I feel like they miss you. They keep thinking about you. They feel lonely without you. Yeah. Like I said, talk to you about what they did. Seven of Swords. They self-sabotaged wearing a mask. They didn't tell you how they felt. They ran away. So they know what they did, and I feel like perhaps they know they should apologize. But they keep running away from that. Ten of Cups. So they know that in order to mend this bridge here, they need to speak up and say something. Say why they ran away, why they gaslighted you, you know. Ten of Cups, I mean, what they think about this is they see a Ten of Cups with you. They want to rekindle this connection. So they saw you as the ultimate happiness. They left you high and dry. They left. For some of you, you could have had kids or a family with this person. And they could have lied. They cheated. They ran away. They self-sabotaged. They were more ego-based. They didn't know how to stay in the bubble of abundance, I guess. So this person has a lot of healing to do also. Ten of Pentacles. I mean, jeez. So what do they think about this connection? They think that it was, yeah, you were the one. We have the Ace of Wands with the Queen of Cups, Ten of Cups, and the Ten of Pentacles. So they're hopeful that they can get this back. But they know if they don't put this mask away and this ego and pride down and apologize for whatever it is they did, or, you know, admit that they were wrong somehow, some way, that, I mean, what are you gonna do? You were everything to this person, but they never appreciated it. They never showed you that. Okay, so let's get into what their fears are here. What are their fears when it comes to your connection? Because there, I see there's a lot of fear and self-sabotage here. One more shuffle. Let's see. I'm here and I hit the ground running. So you made this person nervous, is what I see as well. Let's see what we got when it comes to their fears. That's fear based. So what are their fears? Is the guilt, the remorse, the I spilled the milk. They're fearful that they'll never be able to sleep at night with themselves for whatever they did here. They're fearful that they're never going to get over this guilt. You know, I feel like whatever they did to you, they didn't think that it was going to hurt them as bad as it did. But it kind of like ricocheted back to them. Because you were very compassionate here. This is selfless, you know. Very nurturing energy. And you did love this person. You know, even with his faults. And they didn't know how to handle that. So, let's see what else. Nine of Wands. Wow. In their whole little bubble, they're just a mess. Nine of Wands, they're fearful that they can't get over this. I'm the wounded warrior. You know, woe is me. This defense mechanism that they use to keep people at bay. They're fearful that they're never going to be able to put that guard down. Let's see what else. Yeah, that they're stuck in their ways. That they're not going to be able to see a different perception. Or, you know, they just feel like they're stuck in their ways is what I see here. That there's no growth. Three of Wands, that you're perhaps never coming back. I feel like this is them waiting for their light to come back. You're like the sun to this person, obviously. I see that. Yeah. They're fearful they can't manifest you back into their life. But they're still holding on. They're fearful that they can't let you go either. These are their fears. Yeah, they have a mental block. But they're fearful they'll never be able to make a decision when it comes to you. That they'll always hold on to this and not be able to let it go. Wow. Okay. So let's get into another layer of this. We're going to use the sexual magic tarot here with what are they thinking when it comes to your connection? Let's get another layer of that. One more shuffle. All right, let's talk about this Four of Cups. The King of Pentacles. You know, they could have been perhaps more focused on materialism. All right. Just focused on making that money and missed out on a great opportunity because they were more of the material world. All right, let's talk about the Queen of Cups. So when it comes to your connection, they're still stuck on you. That's what I see here. They're still thinking about you. All right. Also, I see here this person still needs to go through transformation. But you see how he's like still looking at her and admiring her. They still want you to be stuck on them as well, but they're stuck on you. But there's a caterpillar here. Transformation definitely needs to take place in this person. Yeah. So when it comes to this connection, whether you were married to this person or you had a long-term commitment to this person, you know, they know they need to apologize here. Okay. They still choose you when it comes to this connection. Also, I see there might have been some differences when it came to your beliefs, is what I see here. That could have been a big factor when it came to this connection. It was like oil and water when it came to your beliefs. And perhaps also they know they have a lot of growth to do as well, because this is learning. So, are we the student yet? You know, when the student is ready, the teacher arrives. So, perhaps they have a lot to learn as well when it comes to this connection, is what I see. Let's talk about the Seven of Swords. Yeah, they were at the crossroads. So they're still self-sabotaging. They're at the crossroads. They want to be here, but they keep running away. They keep wearing this mask. They want to express how they feel. They are wishy-washy. They keep going between one thought and another. So how they feel is they want to escape, maybe to go see you as well. When it comes to this connection, spark this fire up again. They miss this connection. This chemistry between you was undeniable. I can see that. Maybe they want to run away with you. Because they do want to tell you how they feel, but they keep running away from them. So they watch from afar, where it's safe. They fantasize. Let's talk about the Ten of Cups. Yeah, look at that. It would make them so much happier to if they just put their guard down and come see you. But what's standing in the way is their big old ego and pride. I mean, I keep getting a picture of his head in a helium as a helium balloon. But what they would want the most is to come see you and be happy. They want to be in this happy bubble with you, but they keep running away from it. This is where they want to be. They want to talk to you. They want the spark. They want to spend time with you. They know that you make them very happy. I mean, there's a freaking rainbow when it comes to when you guys are together.
But they keep sabotaging that.
Oh boy. So tell me, what is ego and pride good for? Not when it comes to relationships. No good at all. It keeps you from your happiness. And all you gotta do is say what you gotta say. I mean, who are you trying to impress? Who's judging you for speaking your truth? You know what I'm saying? It's like, I don't know, it's like it goes against their, whoever's beliefs, their family, their friends. Are they really your friends when they don't want to see you happy? If this is what truly makes this person happy is you, what's this ego and pride about? It's got to be within. The healing that needs to take place within so that he can get rid of the mental block. You know, healing must take place in order for you to open up that crown chakra and align yourself to a broader perspective of you, yourself. So let's talk about the Ten of Pentacles.
Yeah, Knight of Pentacles.
They know it's taken them a while, and it still might take them a while. They haven't seen you in a while either. But for them, it's like a super slow process of growth. I mean, this is a snail's pace. So when it comes to the connection, they know that this would be a long-lasting relationship. Because this to me is a long cycle as well. So they know they would be happy with you. This is a pair. It's a fertility. And as you can see, this is fertility manifestations. So they know this would last a long time when it comes to this connection. But the problem is them. It was always their inner healing. Okay, you love them unconditionally is what I see here. So let's go back to the fear. What is the fear when it comes to your relationship? Let's see. Nine of Wands. The Fool. What I feel here, and this is Aquarius or Sagittarius energy, is that we also have Leo, Aries, and Sagittarius, and Sagittarius again. A lot of Sagittarius energy here, but it doesn't have to be. We have Air, Fire, Earth as well. King of Pentacles, Virgo, Taurus, or Capricorn. What I see here is they fear they're always going to be a fool. And not let their guard down, is what I see here. That they're never going to be able to take this leap of faith because they have their guard up and they have a victim mentality. They're hopeful of love and in a relationship, a rekindling, but they have too many fears. So let's talk about the Hangman. Yeah, they're stuck on this passion that they feel for you, okay? They fear that they cannot stop thinking about this, that they can't break free from this passion they feel. Ace of Wands twice. This person is stuck on this connection because of the amount of chemistry. There's like a special like chemical endorphin euphoria type of energy between you guys is what I'm getting here. Very, very inner. It's like sacral, your root chakra and sacral chakra. It's deep rooted in passion is what I'm feeling here, and they can't shake it. But it's also connected in the heart space, I feel. So let's talk about the Three of Wands. Yeah, Four of Pentacles again. They keep holding, they're fearful that they keep holding back for perhaps coming to see you and having this conversation. but also they're fearful that they're always going to hold on to you coming back to them and feeling empty-handed. So let's talk about the magician, the tower. They fear that this is over, that perhaps you will be with someone new, and that they cannot manifest this again with the magician and the tower. That's what they fear, that you're done for good. There is no looking back. All right, let's talk about this Four of Pentacles. Yeah, Five of Wands. Competition, not letting go. They fear they're always going to be in a constant tug of war within their mind about should I, shouldn't I. So they're at a war with themselves emotionally and mentally. But they're fearful that they can't let you go even if you find someone else, is what I see here as well. Which would just break this person. Yeah, Two of Cups. They fear that no matter how much they try to block you out, like I said, you guys are connected in the heart space. This is soulmate energy. You guys mirrored each other in the heart space and also passionately here. I just feel like this connection is deeply rooted within your core, your soul. Okay? And no matter how much this person tries to block it, they fear they'll never be able to. Okay? Because you guys mirror, you could be blocking each other at this time as well, trying to ignore this connection, but it's undeniable. Even if you want to shake it off or move forward, or you know, you don't want to be with this person because of what they did, I just feel the heart will, in the heart space, the love will always remain no matter how much either one of you tried to block it out. It's unconditional love is what I feel here. No matter what, because you love this person no matter who they were, but you knew you couldn't stay in it, obviously, if they did you dirty. They played with your heartstrings. No one should stay in a connection that way. But this is like bigger than both of you. It's rooted on a soul level. So you guys were soulmates, or are soulmates, I should say. But it was like an impossible connection again because of either beliefs, also obviously because this person had a lot of healing and growing up to do, I feel here. They could have cheated, lied, mistreated, gaslighted, ghosted, but they can't shake you, and they're afraid that they'll never be able to let that go. Wow, this is deep. For whoever needs this reading, this is deep. So let's get into my manifest deck here and get another layer of what are they thinking when it comes to this connection at this time. A lot of sexual energy, a lot of passion and love. I mean, they're still watching you. One more shuffle. Still watching. All right, King of Pentacles. Yeah, I cheated because I'm a player. I am a toxic, selfish lover, self-involved, and a taker. So with the King of Pentacles and the Four of Cups, this is someone that always sabotages relationships because they have deeper rooted issues. So they focus on the material world. It's the only thing that brings them satisfaction, is to just focus on work, because it keeps them from being in the Nine of Swords. But when they come home at night, boom, it's like activation of the brain, of the guilt, the remorse, things that they hide in the closet. This person has a lot of skeletons in his closet. Let's talk about the Hangman with the Queen of Cups. Divine Feminine. You're a goddess, beautiful inside and out. I love everything that you are. There you go. So this could even be a twin flame connection, or they just see you as a goddess. They're stuck on you. Okay, this person could see you at this time as the Divine Feminine, twin flame connection, if they've been doing research. It all depends on where this person is at on his level at this time. But I still feel there's obviously they're in fear-based mode. So let's talk about the Hierophant with the Page of Pentacles. Yeah, I fell in love without ever touching you. This love is unreal. It's one of a kind. Oof. And you see the energy emanating here? There's fire, healing. I mean, you guys are definitely connected and on a level that was beyond your understanding in the physical realm. So there's a lot to learn here. And trust me, just as he's learning, I'm sure you've learned quite a bit. There is a lot to learn here. And that's why you guys triggered each other so much. Wow. This is an intense connection. Deeper than you know. Okay. So let's talk about this Seven of Swords with the Two of Wands. Yeah, blind desire, the unknown, open to trying new things, intoxicating, it's so fire. Yeah, it's like they loved it when you guys didn't even sleep together before this person fell for you. It was like instant is what I see here. Whether you guys slept together or not, this was a brief encounter, a friendship, a relationship. It could be anything like that. But what I see here is that, I mean, it was like hook, line, and sinker when they met you, but it scared the bejesus out of them. Mm-hmm. It was like they like being here with you, right? Talking to you, getting to know you, this chemistry, this bubble of fire between you, blind desire, the unknown, open to try new things, intoxicating. It was like being spellbound. It was alluring and like I said, it was like euphoric, like you guys were on a high. But then it scared the shit out of them when it wasn't no longer about the passion. It became the emotional. Boom, he was gone. He or she. Okay. So let's talk about Ten of Cups with the Three of Wands. Yeah, I'm completely obsessed and addicted to all that is you. I love your scent, your touch, your caress. I got it bad. I mean, look at this. Euphoria, I'm telling you. This was like on a whole nother level, this connection. I mean, I'm feeling all kinds of feels. I feel like I'm the helium balloon. So when I talked about the helium balloon with the ego sense, it was like you guys were both like a helium balloon when it came to this passion and this love. It's so spiritual, it's so soul-based. I mean, it's intoxicating. Look at this. They're completely obsessed when it comes to this connection. And I feel both of you felt that. It was on a whole nother level. So it's no wonder they can't let you go. And this is a connection you will always think about. Okay, for those who are resonating with this type of connection. All right, I'm not just talking about some random karmic past lover. We're talking about a soul connection here. Someone that ran away from it because it was very intense, from what I can see. Very intense. Alright, so let's go into what their fear is when it comes to this. Obsessions, passion, desire, wow, love. You guys had the perfect elixir, except you guys weren't healed when you came together. So that's why the connection was bigger than you guys. You had to part ways to do a lot of healing. That's why I feel this could be a twin flame connection here. So let's talk about the Nine of Wands and the Fool. Yeah, can you ever forgive me? Genuine apology, guilt, regret. Please forgive me, reaching out. Now, this has to do with the fear, Nine of Wands with the Fool. So they fear they're never ever going to be able to give you that apology, that genuine apology that you need, because their guard is still up. And you see that double-butted rose? You guys are connected. Yeah, it's like you were born from the same soul. This is definitely like a twin. This has to be a twin connection. This is intense. You guys are definitely connected on a soul level. Wow. I can feel the intensity of this connection. A lot of pain was had here. Oof. A lot of pain was had here. Okay, so let's talk about the Ace of Wands and the Hangman when it comes to their fears. Yeah, they still stalk your social media, lurking, watching someone from your past. So they're stuck on you. They fear they're never going to be able to break free, and they can't. You stemmed from the same portal, which is you, your inner core. You're connected. That bud can't ever break free from this other bud. It grew together. That's intense. It's like being a Siamese twin in a spiritual level. That's how intense this is. On a soul level, you guys have a soul bond that it can't be broken. Oh man. This is a very difficult connection though. Wow. This was not an easy twin connection, that's for sure. Not that they are, but this connection, whoa. On a whole nother level. So, let's talk about the magician here. Actually, let's talk about the Three of Wands with the Four of Pentacles. I can't stand thinking about the possibility of you being with someone else. I'm scared that you might have options. I'm stuck in another situation. I can't break free at this time. So definitely they could be with someone else, or they just feel stuck where they cannot, I feel you guys have some distance as well, but they're afraid that you're with someone else, or that you will be with someone else. They're still holding on to this union with you, of seeing you at some point. So they fear that they won't have that chance and that you'll find someone new. It's funny how, they find someone new and then you find someone new and it's the end of the world. Oh my God. God forbid. So let's go to the Magician and the Tower. Divine gift, travel date, abundance, spoiling, showering you with gifts. Let's make it rain. Yeah. I think that you might be blessed with someone new. So their fear might actually come true. Okay? And the reason that the divine would place someone new in your life, even though this is a twin flame connection, is because this person has a lot of issues. This could take years for this person. All right? And you might be the catalyst to this person being cracked open by hurting this person emotionally even deeper. And I don't mean intentionally, but by being with someone else. Because as we can see, they cannot stand the possibility of you being with someone else. And because this person perhaps is still not doing the healing, the divine is going to find a way to crack this person open. So they're going to have a tower moment. If you manifest someone new here, is what I'm seeing. Because they were meant to change and transform their life this lifetime, and they still haven't done so. Wow, this is deep. So you're manifesting something here, all right? It could be in the form of someone new or an abundant lifestyle. I feel like you're probably perhaps on another level here. Maybe you've done the healing and they just have not. Okay, let's talk about the Four of Pentacles with the Five of Wands because I do see competition here. Yeah, look at this. This person is poison, sleeping with the enemy, red alert, hidden agendas, venomous snake, karmic. So definitely there was karma between you from a past life that you guys had to clear. But what I see here is this person is still a snake. So they have not grown. And again, Five of Wands with the Magician and this tower and this deck, I feel like you are manifesting someone else. And they're going to see that. So let's talk about the Two of Swords with the Two of Cups. There you go. I'm not awakened. Asleep, mental block, limited mindset, and oblivious. And it goes perfect with the Two of Swords. This person has a block and the Hangman. They have a block. They keep going back and forth. Are they my soulmate? Are they not? They want to block this out because they don't believe in this stuff. Alright, this person is asleep. So, they have a lot of issues. And that's why, till this person heals, this is not coming together, if you even want it. Okay? Because this person is a snake still. They still have a challenge here. So, this person could have other types of addictions, sexual addictions. They're still running away from healing. They're at a tug of war with themselves. You know, I just feel like they have some issues here. Yeah, I'm not gonna go into those particular issues because I don't like what I see there, but and I didn't get a card here, so let me go ahead and get a card for the Ten of Pentacles and the Knight of Wands as to what are they thinking when it comes to this connection. They know it would have been long term, but not with the way they are at this time. One more shuffle. Yeah, look at this. You see how he's gifting this person? And it says, will you accept this gift? And it says, red flags, hidden intentions, trickery, manipulative, and illusions. So, what this tells me is two things. The divine is trying to tell you that this person ain't good for you. Not as it stands. They're poisonous. They're full of trickery and illusions and manipulation. They're not awakened, even though you guys have this incredible soul bond. This is bigger than you guys, but there's a lot of passion. I feel like this person is very sexually driven. But when it comes to this connection, perhaps at first, maybe they thought this was too good to be true. It was trickery. You were trying to lure him in some kind of way. Maybe they thought this was some kind of spell that you put on them. But what I see here is if they try to come to you after you haven't seen them in a while, they're still red flags, hidden intentions, and trickery. So they will still come see you to see if they can perhaps have that euphoric feeling that they missed, because I can tell, especially with the connection that was there. They will always run away from it till they heal. So if they come see you, it's because they want this union, this sexual union with you. So be careful with this person. Oh, I hate to see that, but spirit don't lie. So for whoever's resonating, this is not going to resonate for everybody, okay? This is a very unique experience here. Alright, so let's get another layer of this with my Divine Masculine, truth be told, the closer I get to you. Let's get another layer of this when it comes to what are they thinking when it comes to this connection. Wow. Living on the dark side of the moon, yes. So let's see. Yeah. I will tease you till you beg for more. I want to satisfy all of your fantasies. I aim to please you in every way possible. Let's play. You see this with I cheated because I'm a player. I am a toxic, selfish lover, self-involved and taker. So this person is a tease. They will tease you, they will toy with you because they're just looking to get laid. So they have deep rooted issues when it comes to their heart space. This person could have had childhood traumas when it came to their mothers. They didn't have that motherly love, or the mother was absent in their life, and it created this persona and this fear when it came to love and seeing anyone that loves them for who they are, because this person does not feel good enough, I can tell, for you. They're gonna run away from. So that's what I see there. So let's see Divine Feminine when it comes to this connection. Boom, fireworks. It was fireworks. Magnetic fusion. Yeah, they felt it. Mm-hmm. You both felt it. It was out of this world. It was like, pfft, sparks fly, baby. It was, yeah, I told you, this connection is crazy. It's just intense, intense. It was like you guys were cut from the same cloth, but it was like the yin and the yang, like you were the light energy and they were the dark energy. But they need balance within themselves. Right now they're living too much in the dark side. And their light energy is that little circle in the yin and yang. Where is that? Excuse the chart, this is other things that I have going on here. But they're in this side and this is their light. And you're over here. See what I'm saying? So you guys were yin and yang, but there was no balance between there. That he needs to get out of the dark side of the moon, you know what I mean? Alright, so let's talk about I fell in love without ever touching you, the Hierophant, and the Page of Pentacles. Oh, there you go. My heart is in your hands. So you see how you guys are both connected? You guys have a contract, soul contract together. You guys are connected with that red string of faith in the heart space. Oh man, these are difficult. I know. These are very, very difficult. Oh, but good Lord. It's like you guys just, this bond is... I hate to see this because this person has so much growing to do. Wow. Let's talk about blind desire with the Two of Wands and the Seven of Swords. Yeah, travel plans. Like I said, this person is hopeful that they can have this feeling with you again, but they're going to run away when it gets too deep because they are not awakened and they are still a snake. It's like having a relationship with the devil, unfortunately. The devil fell in love. The angel, you know, the angels and demons, you know, I mean, the desire keeps bringing him back. This is a hell of a... I just hate seeing this. It's like being condemned to a connection that is no good for you. At this time, definitely not good for you. Will it ever be? We'll get to that. Let's talk about I'm completely obsessed and addicted to all that is you with the Three of Wands and the Ten of Cups. Working on my skills and thinking of you. So I don't know what they're doing. Maybe they like to write music. Maybe they play a certain instrument, whether it's the guitar, the piano, whatever it is that they do. I don't know. Maybe they have a skill you know nothing about. Who knows? And let's talk about, will you accept this gift? Yeah, I can't wait to have my toes in the sand next to you. So they could want to travel somewhere along the water with you, on the beach, lake, river, or you live by water, or they do. And be careful because this, I can see what this person's gonna do. They have travel plans to come have sex with you.
It's the sex they want. With the Seven of Swords, they're going to escape again. But this is what they're going to promise you. I want a long-term commitment. But it's trickery to get you into the bedroom. Manipulative and illusions. They want to spend time with you and give you fake promises because they want to have sex with you. The messed up part about it is that they're asleep, but their soul keeps bringing them back to you because there is love here that they don't want to admit to. And if they come here towards you with the intention of sleeping with you and running away, they're just going to mess themselves up even more. Not only you, but themselves up, because they're going to take this emotion with them as well. So they still think they could pull the wool over your eyes. I'm letting you know that they're going to end up messing themselves up. So don't sleep with this person. I'm telling you, do not do it. They're not healed. They're still poison. They're still very conflicted. They have someone else in their life as well, as from what I see here. Don't do it. Don't fall for it. Okay? Even if you're connected as deep as you are, this person, I'm telling you, they're going to promise you this, the moon and the stars, because they want to get laid. And then they're going to leave you high and dry. Don't do it. Alright, so let's go to their fears. Let's go to their fears and what is currently happening. What are their current thoughts? So let's get a few more cards here. One more shuffle. What else when it comes to fear, and what are their current thoughts? This is more than complicated, boy. Yeah, if you only knew the things I want to do to you. I see that. Encounter. So their current thoughts is that they want this encounter badly. Badly. They want a piece of you no matter how. Yeah, meet me halfway. I'm telling you. Karmic drama. Yeah, told you they had someone else not getting her way. Yeah, there was someone else. So they want to cheat on the person they're with because they want to be with you sexually. And then they're going to run back to the other person, I'm telling you. So they could be having a lot of arguments with the person they're with. And they just want to be with you right now. They want to escape. I release what no longer serves me. Yeah, I feel like they're trying to get away from this person. There's a lot of drama. And I want to dance to the beat of our own drum. See what else? It's going to be a wet ride. Ready to explore every inch of you. I see that. And I have spoken to complete strangers about this connection. So they're having a lot of issues in their karmic situation. So they need an escape. And you are that escape. You are that euphoria, that Ten of Cups, that Ace of Wands, that soul bond that they miss and haven't had. It's like a drug, a fix. And that's what they want, is their fix. Because they're going through drama in their karmic situation. But then, I'm telling you, it's trickery. They're going to run back to this person. This person is very sneaky, very manipulative. Remember, they are not awakened. Do not trust this person at this time. So that's a warning. Red alert. Red alert. All right. Let's see. What else? Let's get a few messages here. All right. Let's get a few messages. So their current thoughts is you, because they're going through some karmic drama. One more shuffle. So this person's gonna, they gaslighted you and now they want to do love bombing. That's what I see.
because they want to get laid. Yes, you guys have a connection, but mentally this person is not right. And they're not healed emotionally. So they're still in the taking, trickery, manipulative mode. This is too much. You see? With love call, someone expresses love, a message of love, thinking of you and letting you know. Very soon. Mm-hmm. Looking at your photographs. Okay. And with the mask, I'm not sure. So the message of concern is going to be for you, I feel here. Let's talk about this is too much. Yeah, you're done for now. Okay, I think that's you. I'm telling you, they're going to turn into Pepe Le Pew all of a sudden. Ma chérie, my petite fleur, come with me to the Casbah. We will make beautiful music together. I'm telling you. This is exactly what's happening. I see you differently now.
I love you. I give you the world.
Yeah, they can't break free though. And you're going to feel like you can't break free from this person. Because they're going to lay it on thick. Be careful. Oh, be careful. This person is dangerous. Oh, so dangerous. And let's get a couple cards here from the one true love messages, because you guys have a soul bond. I feel this is a twin flame or soulmate energy, but this is a damn deep soulmate energy if it's a soulmate energy. One more shuffle. Pepe Le Pew. Sorry, but I can just see this person in action already. My goodness. I love your inner strength and confidence. Mm-hmm. I'm putty in your hands. Oh yeah, they want something to be putty, alright. Oh Lord. There you go. Alright guys, we've addressed the elephant in the room. Let's get a couple messages from Spirit. And then we're going to leave this here. If you don't get clarity, make sure, then remember though, this is general, so you really gotta resonate with this soul bond that you have towards someone that you separated from because they did you dirty. It could have been a friendship where you guys had feelings and you thought that, you know, you guys were gonna get together and be together, or it could have been a brief relationship or date, you know, you guys were dating for a little bit, maybe, perhaps. But the bond is where you'll know if you resonate with this reading. This is definitely not some random Joe Schmo, even if they acted like it. You would know if you had these feelings, because they're like unlike any other. All right, let's see what Spirit has to say. Criticizing one another will only lead to further unhappiness. Love and accept each other as you are, and your relationship will magically transform. Now, I agree with that. Yes, unconditional love, no matter what. Which you love this person unconditionally, no matter what. The problem lies with the trickery, the manipulation, and the fact that this person is still asleep and wants to get away with just having sex and not show up for the connection itself. That's the problem. But obviously, you have the power to sleep with this person or not. You can just hear him out or her and enjoy the moment, but always have that self-love and respect enough to say, okay, I'm happy to see you. I'm glad things are better with you. I'm glad we had this conversation. And now remove yourself from it. Because you don't want to give this person that power again over you so they can stab you in the back. Okay? Forgiveness. Exactly. Stop focusing your energy on past events, for life is too precious to waste. You create your reality by what you think, dream, and imagine. So there you go. Forgiveness. You know, forget the past. Water under the bridge. But again, this person wants to come back. Their heart is in your hands. It says it right here. But there's trickery. There's trickery. You still trigger this person. And you will when they see you again. The passion and the love and all that will rekindle or re-spark. But the trickery, because we're not awakened here, is still there. You know, maybe their fear is that they're not going to be able to see, you know, meet you at this level because they keep running away from, they're afraid of intimacy is what I see here. The Two of Cups, they're afraid of being this vulnerable with you. And that's the issue. Now, they could be sleeping with the enemy, with a karmic, but I still feel like this person's, I mean, we have player all over the board, basically. But we do have a very deep-rooted, seated soul bond that is unbreakable here. All right, guys, that's what I have for you. We've addressed the elephant in the room. So that's the ghost of the past that, unfortunately, you are soul bonded to. And a lot of time and healing needs to take place in this connection, separately and together, emotionally, mentally. I mean, wow, the divine really, you guys cross paths in a very heartfelt roller coaster, emotional, sexual energy, undeniable. I almost want to make a word up, unsurpassable. We cannot surpass this type of connection. It's nuts. All we can do is heal, send each other loving energy, forgive each other, move on, and take it one day at a time. And remember that energy shifts and change all the time. Healing can sometimes, you know, awareness and awakening can come in a matter of weeks, days, at least the awareness of that. And just pray for this person. And just be wary. I think you know where your energy lies when it comes to this person, especially if they hurt you quite a bit. You'll be able to pump the brakes when you need to. That's all I can say. The rest is up to you guys to decipher. Whoever's resonating with this, remember, this is not for everybody. This is a undeniable soul bond that, unfortunately, you know, their separation was inevitable because of what was being done. One person, definitely more than the other, was very dark in their energy space. So, and I think you will always have unconditional love for this person. But you know that in this life, when you grow and transform and heal your life, your vibration no longer matches this person. So they would have to raise their vibration in order to meet you back in that space. You will always be connected, but vibrationally, this person is still at a very low vibration. All right? So remember that the divine might place someone new in your life, especially if it's going to take years for this person to grow, okay? Excuse me. So I'll talk to you guys later. Bye-bye. Sorry, I forgot. I wanted to get into, real quick, before you guys left, or did I get into that already? Okay, will there be reconciliation between you guys? That's what I wanted to know. Or are you meant to meet someone new? Let's see. Will there be reconciliation or someone new coming into your life? One more shuffle, my guys. Hopefully you guys didn't click off before I added this last part. Okay, so the divine saying they're in their cocoon, transformation, metamorphosis, entering new phase. So transformation has to take place. I know they must speak their truth. I know I must speak their truth about how they really feel.
Clarity Conversation, Speaking My Mind. And I don't want to make the mistake of cheating on you. Okay. So they need to work on their cheating ways. Be faithful and committed and not give in to their temptation, urges, and, you know, they have to not have this mental block and not hold back. So the divine is saying for this to come together, all of that has to take place within this person. Wow. So they need to drop their mask, speak their truth, go through transformation, and be faithful. And transformation will help them see and heal this cheating ways that they have. Okay, so that's what I got for you guys. Wow. So all of that has to take place in order for this to come together. So will there be new love? Let me get into the Arcanum Tarot. Will there be new love while all of that takes place? Let's see. Two of Cups. So this may or may not be new love. Let's see. Ten of Swords. Knight of Swords. Let's see what else here. The Sun. What I'm seeing here is that the past must be put behind you guys. You both are going, had to go through a transformation. And I don't know why I'm hearing, here I come to save the day. But enlightenment, a new day has to take place between you. And I just feel like you're both returning back to that innocent space, both enlightened in the heart space. And through this, you know, Lionsgate, that could very well happen for this person. All right. Let's see who this Knight of Swords is. Yeah, there you go. So you both can work in balance in the yin and yang towards home. The Chariot follows the star, home. So that's what I see here. Wow. So for you guys, I don't know. I can't tell you how long that's going to take. But what I see is that you guys are meant to be at some point in the future, but you both must be enlightened. So someone here, I feel, is still going through that. All right, so they could be at a knight, you know, they were at a page, maybe now they're at a knight. They need to be the king or the emperor, but you guys need to both be enlightened for this to move forward and come together. Is what I see here. And that could take many years. Many years. Wow. Alright guys, that's what I got. I'll talk to you later. I'll be doing one for new love as well. So look out for that one. Bye bye.